Good evening, everyone. So today we have this webinar on derivatives made simple. Before we start, I would like to introduce myself. My name is Sugreem Vishwakarma, and I am the senior manager here in Angel Broking. And I have an overall experience of 11 to 12 years in stock market. Before we start this, I really like to thank all of you participants out here. You are giving your time to gain knowledge about derivatives. Very few people do that. We have seen people going ahead and trading in market without any knowledge, and they don't succeed. So in order to succeed, it is very important that you have knowledge of what you are going to do or what you're doing. So we will start it now. So in this webinar, what we are going to do is we'll discuss a few basics of derivatives market. We will see how futures and options work along with their potential. Plus, we'll discuss some precautionary things and common mistakes that we should totally avoid while trading in this market. So let us understand what derivative instruments are. So derivatives are nothing but it is a financial instruments which are leveraged in nature. I hope you know the meaning of leverage. Still, let me make you people understand. Taking an example of cash market, we'll take an example of Reliance, which is trading at 1,000 rupees approximately at the moment. So if you want to buy 500 shares of Reliance in cash market and take a delivery of it, you have to have 5 lakh rupees with you, correct? However, in financial market, sorry, in derivatives market, if you want to buy same 500 shares, which is one lot of Reliance right now, so instead paying 5 lakh, you can only pay 75,000, provided the exchange is leaving 15% margin on Reliance contract. So if exchange has asked 15% margin for Reliance, you just have to pay 75,000 rupees to hold one lot of Reliance contract for the expiry that you choose, correct? So that is why we call it is a leveraged product. You get a very high leverage into this. Now, since there is a high leverage, you get an opportunity to make big in this market. One more thing we need to remember is you can trade both the long side and the short side of the market in derivatives, unlike cash market. In cash market, you cannot hold the sell delivery of any stock. However, in futures and options, you can. So there is a great opportunity that a derivative product gives you, and we should definitely be ready for all this. So these are the same thing, like futures are a leverage product, which are exchange traded. There are a few things that you should know in this is, one is lot size, another is expiry date, okay? Then how much premium it is trading at, whether it is trading at a discount or at a premium rate when compared to its cash rate. You should be good in speculation, like in which direction the stock would go to make big in this. Okay, so these are a few things which you should know before you get into future market. Now, let us understand how option contracts are derived. Now, when you look at options, there are two things into this. One is call and one is put. So, when do you buy a call? You buy a call when you feel the stock or the index will rise from the point where you buy it. Similarly, you buy a put when you feel that stock or index will fall from the point where you buy it, right? So, as long as you are a buyer, you get the right to execute it whenever you want to, but you don't get the obligation. It's like you can let that call or put expire worthless. So you don't have any obligation on you to execute that trade once you have taken a buy position into options. Okay. So on the other hand, you also have to understand that if you are a buyer of a call or a put, there is a third person who is selling that call or selling that put to you, right? So, what is his view? Now, in options, you can make three views. One is a bullish view, like when you feel the market will go up. Another is bearish, when you feel it will go down. And the third view is neutral. You don't have any view. That stock or that index might trade in a range of certain points. So if you have a neutral view, then you can sell a call or a put, right? So the person who is selling a call, he's of a view that the stock will not go up or it will remain slightly down or it will trade in a range of so and so points. So that is why he's selling that call to you. Similarly, the one who is selling a put, he is of a view that the stock or that index will not go down or it will stay in a range of certain points. That is why he is selling. So in options, you can have three views based on which you can decide upon your strategy, what side to trade. So what we'll do, we'll understand why you should trade in options, what are its benefit. One is hedging. Options are widely used for hedging. Hedging means it is if you have an existing position in cash market or futures market, you can hedge it with options to avoid risk on a downside or on an upper side. So I will take an example here. Let's say you have Reliance of 500 shares in cash. Okay, you are holding it. You are getting benefit out of it in terms of bonuses, splits, dividends, and everything. So, but you have a risk. Like if tomorrow Reliance goes down by 10%, then your value in Reliance will go down by 10%. So if you have that risk associated with your cash position, you can hedge it with option by buying a put of Reliance of the same strike. So when you buy a put of a Reliance, even if Reliance goes down, you have a put to cover all the losses that you are getting in cash. However, there will still be a loss if it goes down, but it will be limited to the premium that you are paying for a put, right? So you can use this option very effectively for hedging your existing position. Secondly, you get attractive returns into this. Like we have seen 50 rupees option going to 500. Then 50 rupee option going to 250, 300 also. So making multiple fold profits into option market is very easy, except I mean, provided you have you are a good speculator, you can make a good judgment of the trade that you are taking. And what is your risk? Your risk is only 50 rupees that you are buying the option strike, right? So it is a limited risk and high rewarding market. But when played with full knowledge and when you have got a good direction into it. So there are times when volatility in that stock or index helps you in gaining big. So option market comes with volatility, which drives the premium on the upper side or on the lower side. So this also helps you. Plus, it works in all the market. It can work in trending market, upside, downside, as well as in ranging market. So this effective option market is. So definitely you should go ahead and take advantage of it, right? So in order to understand this, we will understand a little math on it, like how whenever you encounter different scenarios, what happens to existing positions. So we have two people out here, Harish and Manish. Harish is a person who is buying Nifty futures at 11,500 level, and Manish is a person who's bought a call at 100 rupees for 11,500 strike. So they both are of a view that Nifty will go up, right? That is the reason Harish has bought it and Manish has bought a call option. Now we'll take one scenario where Nifty falls by 100 points. What will happen to Harish? Harish will lose 100 points, correct? So Harish will lose 100 points on 75 quantity because one lot of Nifty is 75 quantity. So he'll lose 7,500. Now he had paid a margin of 90,000 rupees to get one lot of Nifty futures. So he incurred a loss of 7,500 on 90,000 capital, which is approximately 8% he lost. On the other hand, if you look at Manish, Manish has lost 65 rupees. Considering a delta value of 0.65% for this strike of 11,500, the call option, which was bought at 100, when it falls by 100 rupees, it will fall by 65 rupees. So the same 100 rupees call option will become 35 rupees. So Manish also incurred a loss of 65 rupees into it, which is 4,875 on an investment of 75 into 100, that is 7,500. So approximately he lost 60% into it. Let us look at other scenario where market rises by 100 points. What would be gain of both these people? Harish will gain 100 points, that is 75 into 100, so he'll gain 7,500. So again he got 8.3% on his total investment. Now Manish, on the other hand, he gained 65 rupees considering a delta value of 0.65% for this call strike. So when Nifty rises by 100 points, this call option will go up to 165, right? So he will make a profit of 4,875 on an investment of 7,500. That is 65% return on investment of 7,500. So that is why we were saying that options comes with attractive return. However, it comes with high risk also, unless and until you have applied some kind of strong risk management to it, right? So we can always capture a low risk and high rewarding trade in options by trading wisely. So these were the two scenarios that we covered. There is another scenario where Nifty is neither going up nor coming down. It settles at same level of 11,500. So what will happen to Harish? Harish will neither make a loss nor profit. So he will have no return on his investment. Whereas Manish, on the other hand, will lose all his 100 rupees because during expiry, if Nifty settles at 100 rupees, the premium that he has paid will become zero, right? His option, call option, would expire worthless, so he will lose all his 100 rupees. So he might lose 100% of its total value. So this is how it will work on different scenarios. Now let us see how we will win in options by applying certain rules to it. So these are some do's and don'ts that you should always follow. One is you should stay away from deep in the money and deep out of the money option. Why? Is because deep in the money and deep out of the money option has a very little probability of making a profitable trade. So out of 20 trades that you will take, maybe one trade will give you profit out of it. So it is as same as buying a lottery ticket when you are trading deep in the money option or out of the money option. Always go for slightly out of the money. I mean 3 to 4 levels up or 3 to 4 levels down. Out of the money you can trade. Just one level up and down you can also look for in the money option, and out of the money option you can definitely go for. So there is always an opportunity in options market to gain big. So you should always look forward to it for look for an option strategy that we can implement in different market scenarios to make good profit out of it. Now we'll discuss some of the precautions that we should take while trading in options market. One is you have to follow a trade mechanism. Like you have to apply strict stop loss to the trade that you will take in options market or in any market for that matter. So whenever you are entering into a trade, you should always have stop loss in your mind that you should feed in the system. It is just to limit your losses, right? So if you have decided to take 100 trades in a year or in a month, make sure that this much percent of the loss I would follow in all the trades that I would be taking. Secondly, do not ever trade in the first 15 minutes of the day, because during that time the stock or the index is very volatile. There are so many participants with different sentiments. You will see the stock going up and down at a very fast pace. So after 15 minutes, everything stabilizes and the stock takes a direction either up or down. So you can look at it and trade after 15 minutes of the day. Never ever average on your losing position. Remember, whenever you are doing an average to your losing position, you are adding a quantity, and if the stock still does not favor you, the loss will be big. So unless and until you have some kind of risk management in your mind, you should never go ahead and average onto your losing position. Okay. There is another thing which you should always remember is the value of the option reduces at a fast pace in the last 2 weeks of the expiry. So if you are a buyer of an option, then you should always look at the first 2 weeks of the month to trade. And when you're nearing the expiry by 1 or 2 weeks, then you should shift yourself in the next month. So that the option value does not reduces. It is because of the theta factor in the option, the value reduces at a very fast pace in the last 2 or 1 week of the expiry. Now, when you are a buyer of an option, your losses are limited to the premium that you are paying, as compared to the seller of the option who always stand on the unlimited risk side. So just imagine you bought an option of 50 rupees, which turned to 500 in a day. So if you would have been a seller, then you're making 10 times loss into it, whereas the buyer is making 10 times profit by buying it. So the seller always stand on unlimited risk side. So while you are a seller of an option, again, you have to have very strong risk management application with you. You should know where to exit out of trade. You should know all of that, right? Always preferably we prefer the option trader to be a buyer in the market because it gives them multiple opportunities. So these are some things which you should always remember while trading in options and be cautious on this. Now let us see some common mistakes that traders or investors make when they come into market. One is knowledge, as I addressed you right before this webinar, that you have come here for increasing your knowledge on this subject. So it is very good thing about you. There are people who do not like to read books, who do not like to read videos. They just play the market for the sake of excitement. Sometimes they are lucky, sometimes they are not, but at the end they go out of the market with a loss. Right, so it is very important that you have knowledge of the subject wherever you're trading. Now, so knowledge is one thing which you should always look for. We do have our research team out here, which based on technicals, based on fundamentals, we give calls on stocks and index options. Then we give short-term calls also from here. You can also opt to look at it. So as soon as we give a call, it will reach your terminal, it will reach your mobile application for with stop loss, with target, which you can look upon to trade. Secondly, you always have to have patience in the market, and you have to control your emotions as well. Now, patience, I mean, whenever you are taking a trade, that trade will not turn into profit in a second or in a minute. You have to give it some time to mature, right? So only maturity of a trade can give you profit out of it. So you have to be a little patient when you are taking a trade. And you should never ever be emotionally attached with any stock. So if the trade has hit a stop loss, just get out of it without thinking twice on it. And if the trade is making profit, you should always make a practice of trailing your stop losses on the upper side, just to gain the full profit out of that stock, right? So you should make a practice of controlling your emotions and having patience in stock market. That's how you will stay in a market for longer period of time. The fourth and last thing is risk management. You should apply risk management on each and every trade that you are taking. I will give you one example of risk management here. Suppose you have 1 lakh rupee with you and you want to trade for 6 months, right? And let's say you will take 100 trades in that 6 months. So if you want to take 100 trades, what is the amount of loss that you should be ready to lose in each trade? So it is 1,000 rupees. Right, so 1,000 rupees if you are losing in each trade for 100 consecutive trades, then you will make a loss of 1 lakh rupee. Correct, so that is one type of risk management, like how much is the loss that you should take of the total value which you have with you. Another is you should have a stop loss and target in place, whatever trade you are taking. Now, While you are in options market and you have 1 lakh with you, you should decide how many trades you are going to take, let's say 50. So if you want to take 50 trades in option market, do not ever bet all 1 lakh rupee in buying the option. So if you want to take 50 trades in buying direction, you should take each trade of 2000 rupees value, not more than that. And again, with strong stop loss applied to it. So these are some risk management application that you should always follow before taking a trade, right? So these are the things which you should remember while you are trading futures and options market. Now we will wrap up our session out here. Thank you.